And there's the ready from Somalian. So here we go with the beginning of the playoffs between Nolan and Somalian. Here's the countdown for game one. 3, 2, 1, Tetris. We have a clean start from both players. And they're each going to get their first Tetris. Only getting the first just by about 1 second. And the efficiency continues as both players are able to get their second Tetris without having to burn yet. There's a nice T adjustment for the JPs from Somalian. Somalian having to put an L on the right for some burns. And there's a Tetris for Somalian getting clean and going to 71,000 points. Now it's Nolan's time to take a few burns due to an unwanted S piece and then another one. Finally has the board, it's able to accommodate an S piece. He scores a Tetris after getting clean and goes to 117,000 points. Somalian also at 117,000, but behind by 380 points. So a very, very slight lead for Nolan at the moment. We have 164 for Nolan, 185 for Somalian. Somalian's going to score again and go to 200,000 points. Both players playing very efficiently. If Somalian, especially efficient with 208,000 already at 40 lines. Nolan's going to cross 200,000 point mark as well at 43 lines. So currently both players are on pace to transition around 650. But we'll see if they're going to be able to maintain this efficiency to the end. These players are continuing to stack very well. Not seeing any trouble from either player. And nice adjustment there from Nolan, pulling the L back as he sees the long bar next. He's able to take a Tetris without having to burn with the L. Some strong pace from both players. And now we see a chem tuck there from Somalian. Somalian using the L on the right, it's the easiest way to burn out that S-Tuck setup. Okay, 392 for Nolan, 350 for Somalian. Somalian getting up high, waiting for a long bar. It finally shows up. He's able to get the long bar right for a Tetris. And then another one. Somalian playing a bit aggressive there, but it does pay off. Somalian was probably looking for a long bar to put on the right side. There were plenty of pieces to help Somalian get Tetris ready. But he just decided to throw all of them left, trying to play as efficiently as possible. But there's no long bar in sight for Somalian. Somalian finally gets to the long bar, but the well's blocked, so he's gonna have to wait for the next one to bring the stack down with the Tetris. Somalian's continuing to try to get the board in shape while trying to survive this drought, and the L goes right for a triple, and there's a double with the square. Somalian's still trying to hold out for this long bar, and it's not showing up. He's able to get a triple, but blocks the well as the lumbar shows up. He's able to get it left to open up the right side again. Hangs an O, but gets the Tetris to bring his stack lower. Somalian, unfortunately, losing quite a bit of pace there to a drought. He does some really smart burns, though, to open up a hole that was created. Somalian's back to scoring. Nolan, in the meantime, has quite a bit of weight on the right side up high. Oh, yeah. That was a crazy drought, which resulted in some crazy taps. Oh, and Nolan's in some trouble. Like a J or a long bar, gets the long bar. Now with like an L. And unfortunately, he's going to hang the L piece and top out at 529. So Somalian at 559 will take the first game. And with both players ready, let's get game two started in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. First Tetris of the game is going to go to Nolan. Somalian answers back, going to 22,000 points with the Tetris. Welcome in, Peekayric. And also Miles. I didn't say hi to Miles. I'm bad. Alright, we have a bit of jaggedness from both players. And each of them having to take a couple of burns to get the board situated. Somalian looks to be in a bit of a lengthier dig. Nolan's already clean. So Nolan has an opportunity to start building a lead. And Nolan's able to score a Tetris and go to 122,000 points. Somalian at 100,000. He's getting closer to completing the dig. And now just need some helpful pieces to get the right side back open. And Somalian was clean. Had four rows set up completely flat, so had a chance for a perfect clear, but Lombard showed up a piece too late. A nice L burn from Somalian. Fortunately, the pieces that came afterward are a bit trickier. And Nolan's in a bit of a mess right now. Having to work with less than ideal pieces. And Nolan's almost out. And that T is going to open up the right side for Nolan. Now he just needs a long bar for a Tetris. There it is. Tetris for Nolan takes him to 225. Smalling with some high up burns. Able to get the right side back open for a Tetris of his own. 227 now for Nolan. 169 for Smalling. Somalian scores a Tetris and goes to 191 with both players at 64 lines. You can see a 30,000 point difference, or 38,000 between the players in favor of Nolan. So Nolan has currently about a 2 Tetris lead when considering the line count. Nolan with the nice back-to-back adjustments, putting the L up. I mean, putting the J piece upside down for the T, and then adjusting the T for the long bar. And there's a nice Z overhang for Nolan for the S tuck, but unfortunately the S had nowhere good to go. Now he's looking for a good piece to deal with that awkward overhang, ideally an L. He gets the L for the right side. Now I would like to see a J piece. And there's the J for Nolan. Great pieces there. After having to deal with that awkward S. And he's going to get a Tetris. And now looking for a piece to tuck. He gets a Z and a J for a tuck. So Nolan's board is very clean once again. And he's back to scoring Tetrises. 398 now for Nolan. Nice 5 and below afterward. And a smart delay burn to follow. Somalian at 360 right now. He's currently about one line behind as he gets a Tetris and goes to 384. So Nolan still has a 2 Tetris lead. As both players have now crossed the 100 line mark. Oh yeah, it looks like a bit of a claw grip there for Nolan. My fingers are hurting just looking at that. Let's just start making 5 and below a habit. Me too, yes, absolutely. I finally started doing OJs. 5 and below is next on my list. Here's the Tetris for Somalian, go to 480,000. Nolan is still ahead at 514. And Somalian's ahead by 3 lines, so it looks like Nolan's actually starting to slip just a little bit further ahead in terms of scoring potential. And there's a 506 transition for Somalian. And with that Tetris, Nolan's going to transition at 562. So it's about nearly a 3 Tetris difference between both players. However, this is so close enough that Post will decide who takes this game. Somalian's now having to bring the stack down after a misdrop of the S on the left side. And Somalian's not going to try to go for a column 2 there. Just bring the stack back down and start over with a right well. Somalian enters level 21 with a 546. Nolan gets a Tetris to enter level 21 with 643, so the gap is expanded now to 100,000 points for 4 Tetrises, and Nolan's going to score once again. There's Tetris for Somalian, go to 599. Somalian's ready for another Tetris, and he scores, going into 22 with a 626. Nolan with the Tetris goes to 698. So the gap's closing very slightly, and now Somalian's presented with a chance to catch up some more as Nolan had to put some S's on the right side. And that was a very high up Corian adjustment there on level 22 from Nolan. Incredible reaction time we just witnessed. Holy cow. 740 now for Nolan on level 23. Somalian at 691, now with an awkward board. Then we get the long bar on the right side. And oh, that long bar is not going to make it left. Someone's going to have to... Oh, he gets the next long bar over. That was 9 high. Nice fast tap there from Somalian. And Somalian is setting up for a center well in column 7. Gets the Tetris and goes to level 25 with a 733. Nolan is still ahead, however, at 816 with a clean board. He scores a Tetris and goes to 847. And there's another Tetris to go to 878. Nolan could 1.1 with enough efficiency. And Somalian could be looking for a max. Although that's going to be a little demanding as he doesn't have too many burns to spare for the max out. Nolan currently on 26 now with a 910. He's Tetris ready. Somalian's having to take a couple of burns halfway up the stack. He's able to get the S left and the Z to open up the right side. And he gets the long bar to score a Tetris and a J to fill the dependency. So Somalian's board is looking much better and also lower. And there's another Tetris there on 27. Ooh, Nolan blocked the well high up, but he's able to open up the right side and score a Tetris. These players trying to play as efficient as they can in this last bit of post. And we have a max out now from Nolan entering level 28. And there's another Tetris to go to 1,053,000 points. Somalian at 914. Trying to salvage as many points as he can. He's going to take an aggressive L single. Trying to score as many points as he can before kill screen. And he's set up for Tetris. He's able to get the J all the way left and along with the square, but unfortunately he's forced to continue taking the burns. The lombar is not in sight, and he doesn't get the lombar on column 3, so he tops out at 951. Nolan with the 1.1 in kill screen will take game 2. High scoring game. GG. And Nolan is ready. So is Somalian. So here's game 3 in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. And yes, Mr. Brain, this is best of 7. And given how these players are able to make it to kill screen pretty easily, this could be a match that can take up to an hour, even though it's one set. And both players now have two Tetrises in hand. A nice T-burn from Nolan. Open up the right side, and he scores a Tetris going to 70,000 points. So only taking a couple of burns to stack back in order. Now he's Tetris ready with that S on the right. Somalian is able to score a Tetris and go to 74,000 points. Nolan in the meantime, a bit of a dig. He's got the right side back open. And now just needs a long bar. Ooh, nice L left there for Nolan. But unfortunately the long bar is not going to show up. And he has a line dependency in column 3. He's able to take a double with the Z piece. And open up the right side with a long bar. Can he finally get one in a timely fashion? Well, he's building higher and higher as he's continuing to wait. These long bars are just coming at the wrong time for Nolan. Gets a T left to open up the right side once again. Plugs the well with an L piece right as the long bar shows up. But finally, after high up burning for about 10 or 15 lines, Nolan's finally able to get a long bar at the right time to score a Tetris. And he gets another one to go to 134. As a result of those high up burns, he's now 8 lines ahead of Somalian. Now 12 lines as he scores again, but Somalian brings it back to 8 with a Tetris. And Nolan's also 32,000 points down, so Nolan is currently not in a good position right now. He's ahead in lines and behind in score. But seeing how efficiently Nolan can play, there is a chance that he can catch up, especially if Somalian slows down. Sort of like that for top 8 CWC since they don't do double elimination at that stage. There's pros and cons for both doing single elimination or double elimination. Though I don't have any real stakes in that discussion, so I'll just leave everyone with their own opinions. We have 213 for Nolan, 288 for Somalian. Both players are going to score a Tetris. And Somalian sets up a delayed Vitz with the S piece on the right. So we get the long bar to the tuck and the next long bar to score. So that delayed Vitz is going to pay off for Somalian. And an overhang setup. Some tucks for Somalian, and that's going to cause a hole. And Somalian now is going to convert it to a dirty Tetris setup. But he's going to burn out of Tetris readiness and continue taking some more burns. So this can actually be the slowdown that Nolan needs to start catching back up. He was down by almost 100,000 points at one point. And now he could actually start to make this deficit up. He's able to get a Tetris, but Smalling gets clean and scores a Tetris at the exact same time. So the gap is going to remain nearly three Tetrises in favor of Smalling. And Nolan's still four lines ahead. So looks like Smalling's going to continue having the pace advantage as well as the score advantage, as these players are now entering the final third of level 18. Now it's 360 for Nolan and 435 for Somalian. Both players are clean and in a position to continue scoring more Tetrises. Nolan, however, does have a J dependency. He's able to get the J piece to fill it in and takes a pair of burns to get Tetris ready. And there's Lombard for Nolan to score. Tetris going to 384. Somalian with a Tetris goes to 482. Just like that, the gap is now 100,000 points. Smalling is able to cross the 500,000 point mark with still 17 lines to go before transition. Smalling also makes a nice S adjustment for the J piece. Ooh, and Nolan's in a bit of trouble. Gets a helpful long bar for a triple and a split double with the J piece afterward. Nolan's potentially one burn away from getting the right side open. And he's going to get the T to take a single to open up the right side and transition with a Tetris at 444. Smalling still has one more Tetris available as he goes to 574. And Nolan's building high up, waiting for a Tetris. Speaking of Tetris, Smalling's going to Tetris into transition with 599. And he's going to throw the long bar all the way left, probably not realizing it was Tetris ready. And Nolan currently high up on level 20 digging. Nice T double. And he's finally able to open up the right side. Great survival there from Nolan up top. But he needs a Lombard to score a Tetris. There's the Tetris. And he gets a nice J double to continue bringing the stack lower and lower. And Nolan's in a much safer position now. He gets a Tetris and goes to 524. Smalian currently enjoying a 100,000 point lead at 641. And a level back on top of that. We have Nolan currently at 554. He's going to get a Tetris and go into 23 with 583. Smalian in the meantime set up for a column 9 Tetris late level 21. And a score of 650,000 points. Finally, Smalling is able to get the Tetris and transfer the well back to column 10. Smalling set up for another Tetris, currently 680 on level 22. Then I enter level 23 with a Tetris going to 709. Nolan still behind at 642 and also a level ahead. So Nolan's going to have to try to play more efficiently than Smalling for the rest of post. But Smalling's not making it easy. He still has a clean board and he's Tetris ready. There's a Tetris for Somalian to go to 770 into 24. Nolan enters 25 with 678. So the gap has once again reached 100,000 points. Ooh, Nolan's able to get that Z left and open up the right side in time for a Tetris. And just like that, Nolan almost caught up. Though there's still the line advantage for Somalian. So still has some more. So Smalian still has more runway to work with. Nolan's up high. He's able to get a Tetris and another one. So 852 for Nolan, briefly taking the lead. Though he's still a level back. Well, Smalian's still a level back. Smalian's now set up a dirty center well there in column 3. Gets the long bar for the Tetris. Now he's looking for another long bar now that there's a dependency. So we'll get the long bar to fill it in and sets up another Tetris on level 27. 924 on level 28 for Nolan. 918 for Somalian on level 27. And Nolan gets a Tetris into kill screen at 961. He's set up for a left well. Can he get the long bar? No, he can't get it left. So that's going to be it for Nolan. Somalian with that Tetris goes to 986 and takes game three. And we could see a mid-max out here from Somalian. There's the long bar for the Tetris. Oh, he's going to overshoot the J, so I'm going to be able to get one more Tetris. But GG's to Somalian. This is an incredibly close set. These players are both capable of maxing out in comp. And there's two readies in chat, so it's time for game four to begin in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Delayed vits from Nolan with a T-piece. And a long bar is nowhere in sight for Nolan, so it looks like this isn't going to pay off. Finally gets the long bar for the tuck, and wow! That was an incredibly fast J left. Oh, his board's not working out for Nolan. He needs a long bar right now, or at least something to go right. He's going to get the L for a single, but that's all he's going to be able to do, topping out at 5,000 points. So Somalian at 68,000 will take game four. Also, welcome in Cheese and Easy Boy. And Pumpy Heart. Yeah, big oof. For an unfortunate outcome in game four. So here's game five as both players are ready. 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Falling quickly, ticking Nolan to match point. We have a little bit of trouble from both players. There's some jaggedness from Nolan and already some burns from Somalian. And Nolan, for a brief moment, had a dirty Tetris setup. Now he's set up again. Can he get the long bar for this Tetris? Takes a double and stays Tetris ready, but he's going to burn out of it afterward. It's like he set up one more time. Nolan's just gonna burn once again. Where's the long bar for Nolan? And Nolan's just gonna bring the stack all the way back down with quite a large drought. Nolan was looking to try to uncover the hole before bringing the stack down. Unfortunately, didn't work out. Nolan's going to continue taking some burns. Somalian, in the meantime, has the lead at 61,000 points. Nolan at 30,000 and is yet to score Tetris, but Nolan's finally clean, so he's able to begin scoring from here. Somalian with a center well setup and column 5 Tetris off the bottom. He's going to be able to get the long bar for this. The lack of long bars is causing both players trouble, and now the well's blocked for Somalian. Now Somalian's going to need something for the right side, preferably a long bar. And Somalian's able to get the long bar. He's able to continue taking burns. Oh, but he overshoots the T-piece! And Somalian's going to top out at 71,000 points, so Nolan at 121 is already good and will take game 5. All right. Here we go with game 6 in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. Nolan's looking to take this game and force a decider, while Somalian's looking to hurry up and close the set already and try to get a nice spot in Division 2. There's Nolan with a nice 5 and below. Does a nice L adjustment for the square piece. There's another T adjustment for a Z piece for Nolan. Nolan's adjustment game is great. Both players now have two Tetrises, Smalling with an additional burn. Now Nolan's taking a couple of burns, but he's going to be able to open up the right side, score a Tetris, and go to 69,000 points. Wow, what a fast S left there from Somalian. Somalian's going to score a Tetris, go to 69,000 points as well, after Nolan goes to 92,000, so Nolan's going to be keeping this lead for the time being. And now we have a dead tie as Somalian scores a Tetris. Nolan now having to take a few more burns. And now quite a few more burns. He's not getting the right pieces. Now Nolan would like an L over Lombard. He gets the L. And in the meantime, Smalling's going to be opening a lead. Currently at 141,000 points, but Nolan's going to get clean and score a Tetris, closing the gap as he now has 127,000, but Smalling's going to score again. Nolan trying to keep the gap from opening too large. Currently have 211,000 for Somalian and 173 for Nolan. And these players are only a line apart, so this is a real two Tetris lead for Somalian. And Kingsman raiding with a party of 7. Thank you. Welcome on in, Raiders. Yeah, I remember seeing a Kingsman restreaming the playoff between Time Locked and Rory. So, Kingsman, how did that go? Rory sweeps to stay in 7. Okay. Alright, Nolan's looking for a long bar for a Tetris, taking a couple of burns in the meantime. Nice S double to uncover the hole, and finally he's able to get a Tetris and another Tetris. We have 251 for Nolan, 288 for Somalian. Only with a fast O left. Oh, Somalian missing the double tuck. And now he's forced to take some more burns to get the stack cleaned up. There's a nice double with the J piece. And that S is going to open up the right side for Somalian. He's able to get a long bar for a Tetris to go to 340. And another long bar to go to 363. A nice S adjustment for the J piece. And I keep calling J's L's for some reason. I don't know what's going on there. But either way, Somalian has a 2 Tetris lead still. However, being ahead by 4 lines means that in terms of scoring potential, it's more like 1 Tetris. Now it's a T-spin setup for Somalian. He didn't want to put the O in the well. T-spin setup has been reopened after it's blocked, but it's gonna plug it instead of waiting for the T-piece. So Somalian with these burns, is not in a good position to continue scoring due to the shape of the board. But Nolan's also not in a position to score right now unless he goes dirty. He's got now two rows of weight on the right side. But Nolan's able to get clean and score a Tetris and go to 397,000 points. Now just one Tetris away from Somalian. These players are only a line apart, so the game really has gotten close. And there's another Tetris for Nolan. While Somalian's digging, so Ooh, nice dirty Tetris there for Somalian to recover at least a little bit of pace while digging. Tetris for Nolan. So 443 now for Nolan, 446 for Somalian. This game is very close right now, but Somalian's still digging. So Nolan has an opportunity to get the lead, but there's a dirty Tetris for Somalian to halt Nolan's progress on the lead. Nolan with the Tetris goes to 465, but still puts him 8,000 points back. But Somalian's continuing to take more burn. So with that Tetris, Nolan's going to get the lead and go to 489,000 points. Now just 9 lines away from transition. Somalian 4 lines away from transition. Somalian's potentially setting up a row 2 Tetris. Instead, due to the pieces he was getting, was forced to take a double into transition. But he hits a nice S-spin. And there's a long bar for a triple on the right side for Somalian to go to 493. Nolan with a 538 transition. Nolan's able to get clean. And Somalian's just continuing to dig. Fortunately, just costing more and more ground. And Somalian's going to set up for a column 3 dirty and get the Tetris. Fortunately, that S is not going to go all the way to columns 2 and 3. So, Somalian's got a few more burns to take. Good stack situated. There's a nice triple with the long bar for Somalian. Nolan with a Tetris goes to 628. The lead for Nolan's expanded almost to 100,000 points now. And Somalian's still digging, except this time now halfway up the stack. Somalian would like to see a J piece to go left or a long bar. There's a long bar. And another long bar, but misdrops it in column 3. Gets the next one over. And Somalian's able to continue digging. And all the while, Nolan's continuing to score Tetrises. Currently, Nolan's at 687,000 points. And oh, Somalian was trying to adjust that L, seeing a long bar next for the Tetris. But unfortunately, he's going to cover the well by misdropping it. Oh, and the hang of the T-piece. Somalian is going to top out at 562, and Nolan at 745 takes game 6 and forces a decider. So we are going to be seeing a game 7 in the playoffs between these two players. Yeah, that was a very unfortunate suffer post there for Somalian, as his transition was somewhere in the 400s. And that J-Hang's gonna keep Nolan from getting a max. Time for game 7 to begin in 3, 2, 1, Tetris. This game will be the deciding factor for who ends up in Division 2 and who ends up in Division 3. Nolan's going to get the first two Tetrises of this game. Somalian starting off with some burns. Is going to have an early two Tetris deficit to try to overcome. Nolan's able to score a third Tetris, going to 68,000 points. Somalian gets clean and scores his first Tetris of the game. And now set up for another Tetris. There's a safety double with the JPs for Somalian. And Somalian gets another Tetris, goes 77,000 points. Still two Tetrises behind Nolan, who's played a perfect 20 lines, and he gets another Tetris as well. So Nolan taking as much advantage as possible as the burns that Somalian had to take in the beginning. But now with Nolan dealing with some jaggedness in his stack, he's going to have a bit of a slowdown that can allow Somalian to catch back up. And Somalian still has a pretty clean board. Hello, Grand Designs. We are in Game 7 between these two players. And we'll be seeing Grand Designs and Peyton face off in a playoff for the playoff in Division 5B, as they are virtually tied in the season. We have 196 for Nolan. He's going to get a Tetris and go to 218. 197 for Somalian. He's trying to get the right side reopened. He's able to do so. And there's the long bar for the Tetris to go to 221. With both players at 56 lines, we can see that Nolan has a one Tetris lead. Hello, Peyton. After 5 seasons stuck in Division 5, hopefully this is the time for me to finally get out of it. I feel that. I don't know what it's like to be stuck in a division for that long. Ooh, nice OJ from Nolan. But, you know, I imagine you're long overdue for a promotion. We have 335,000 points for both players. They're separated just by 380 points. And really, between Grand Designs and Peyton, like, sure, I'm supposed to be unbiased when, you know, commentating, but like, that aside, I genuinely would not know who to root for. Both very respectable players who are capable of putting up some great games. And I like them both. We have 408 for Nolan, 428 for Somalian. Somalian with a one Tetris lead, as they're only a line apart. Thanks, Grand Designs. And both players are now past 100 lines. And we still see that Somalian has a one Tetris lead. And there was an overhang setup for the JTuck or S-spin for Nolan, but unfortunately neither piece showed up in time. So Nolan had to take a few burns, as the setup was then blocked by an L piece. Nolan's going to get clean and score a Tetris and go to 512,000 points. Somalian with the Tetris goes to 568. And now both players have three lines to go before transition, so that Tetris for Nolan will take him to level 19 with a 581. And Somalian transitions with a 593. And gets a Tetris almost right away, going to 618. There's another Tetris for Somalian, go to 642. So we have a very close game here to start in post. Slight advantages there for Somalian, but that can change very quickly depending on who ends up in a digging situation. Tetris for both players, 706 for Nolan, 694 for Somalian. Somalian takes a triple with the long bar, going to 7,000 points and taking a few burns. And just like that, Nolan's going to take the lead by 30,000 points, going to 733. This is a definitive lead as they are still just one line apart from each other. There's a Tetris for Somalian and a Tetris for Nolan. Nolan enters level 22 with 767. And another Tetris for Nolan, go to 796. Both players were really strong paces right now on level 22. 796 to 785. This will be a very high scoring game from both players if they're able to take this to kill screen. Double max seems very likely here. And Somalian's trying to get the right side back open. With like a J piece or a long bar. And there's a long bar for Somalian to open up the right side. Can another one show up for Somalian? Unfortunately, there's a line dependency now on column 8, but he gets a long bar to open up the right side and get something over to the right now. He's not going to get the long bar right and topside at 826, so Nolan, with a 956, will take the decider and remain in Division 2 for next season. And now let's see if Nolan can try to get a 1.2, as there is enough scoring potential for that to happen. Nolan continues this efficiency. Unfortunately, that S was not good for the stack, but he hits a really nice T-spin. And Nolan's going to be able to get out of that bit of an uncomfortable stack very quickly. Look at that. 1,090,000 points. The next Tetris will give him a 1.1. He's going to set up a long bar on column 9. Try to play this as efficiently as he can. Where's the long bar for Nolan? There it is. Tetris will take him to 1,028,000 points into 28. He's got four burns for this 1.2. There's one Tetris. And there's the next Tetris. B98. Looks like he's forced to burn into kill screen, but that's going to be a 1.2 nonetheless for Nolan. And that is going to be way more than enough to take the final game.